first half of Plato's dialogue, Ion, features several arguments about the nature of poetry and about Ion's claims to knowledge about that of which he speaks. And I think if we take a look at the logical structure of these arguments, we can follow Plato's process of reasoning a little bit more closely. It seems to me that we have several related arguments in this first half of the dialogue, and we could represent one of them as a series of conditional statements as follows. If Ion can judge between good and bad poetry, then Ion must know poetry. He must know about, must know the truth about poetry, about the art of poetry. Second, if Ion knows poetry, then Ion is himself an excellent poet. And then third, Ion is not an excellent poet. Ion is merely a rhapsode or performer. He's not going around being the second Homer writing a new Iliad. He simply memorizes and performs Homer before audiences. With those three premises, we can work backwards through a pair of modus tollens inferences. Since Ion is not an excellent poet, Ion does not know the art of poetry completely. And since he does not know the art of poetry, he must not be able to judge accurately and well between good and bad poetry. Now, Plato never comes out and says this latter conclusion in the dialogue, but I think it's there for us, it's there as an inference for us, the readers, to draw. The second set of arguments is of similar structure, and I think it goes like this. If Ion can judge good and bad poetry, then he knows poetry. And if Ion knows the art of poetry, then Ion should be able to judge all poets, not merely Homer. And then third, Ion cannot judge all poets by his own admission. He's only a good judge of Homer's poetry and of other poets only on the subjects on which they agree with Homer. And again, as before, we can work our way now backwards through two steps of modus tollens. Since Ion cannot judge all poets, Ion must not know poetry, and not knowing poetry, Ion must not be a reliable judge of good and bad poetry. So that's a very simple representation, I think, of the modus tollens steps that we can draw out of some of the material that Plato presents in the first half of the Ion dialogue. I hope you found this edifying. Thanks for watching today. Goodbye.